for a miracle. I'm looking for a miracle. Amen. If you are looking for a miracle today, you are at the right place, right? And I touch myself, right? Amen? Amen. Thank you. Looking for a miracle, you are at the right place. So let's lift up your hands and praise the song. Amen. Go ahead, Christina. With the song, let's lead us into devotion. Lead us into devotion.
This is the day. This is the day.
Trying to find their way to Christ. Amen. Our Bible verse is on Genesis 50, verse 15 to 46. It said, because Jacob and Joseph were both faithful to God, Joseph was able to forgive his brother's treachery from so many years before. Remember last week we talked about how when Joseph was a man of power on Genesis 45, verse 3 to 15. He talked about how Joseph was able to hug his brothers, right? He hugged his brothers. He welcomed them. He welcomed them. He didn't hold no grudges. He didn't say, well, because you did all these bad things to me, you know, in the past. He didn't hold no trash. He didn't hold no anger toward his brothers. So he accepted them, and then he gave them a place to stay. He feed them. He gave them shelter. He gave them a whole town apart from where, a whole area apart from where from the Egyptian. He moved them. Oh, he moved them away from from the time because they were a separate group of people. Remember that? Okay. Our memory verse that we have to concentrate on tonight is verse 20. It said, but as for you, he plotted evil against me, but God made it unto good. So bring to the pass as it is this day to save much people alive. Like his brothers thought, Joseph's brothers thought, hey, you know what? I'm gonna do battle to him. I'm gonna sell him up into slavery, right? But guess what? But Joseph said, hey, it was not your plan, it was the plan of God. It was God who made you to do that. So I'm not gonna hold no grudges. I'm not gonna be upset because you sold me off. I'm not gonna be upset because I went to jail. Because now I'm in a position of power so I could help my family, so I could help my people to grow. Yes? That's what he said last week. Okay? So that's why verse 200 said, hey, you know what? You did, even though you tried to do all those bad things toward me, gay, that's okay. That's okay. But I got this because God is in control. Because everything that's happened, God had a reason for it to happen. Anything that happened in your life, anything that happened up to now, God had a reason for it to happen. That's why I said in verse 20, God meant everything to be good. Okay? We need to concentrate as students. As students right now in this Bible class, we need to concentrate that, we need to learn that Joseph truly did forgive his brothers for the evil things that they had done toward him, okay? We need to understand that. Even though people do bad things toward you, you need to learn to forgive them and walk away peacefully. No fighting, no angers, no grudges. Move on, because everything that happened, even though people did bad things toward you, but God had a reason for that to happen, okay? Now, we're going to have Pastor Gustav continue on with our Bible lesson. Pay attention, because you know at the end, we will be asking questions.
Merci, nous remercions Dieu davantage pour privilège de l'union et pour nous capables de s'insérer dans la présence et de nous dire partager parole là parce que dans Osée chapitre 3, il dit que le peuple a mouru, mais c'est faute de connaissance. C'est connaissance de la parole de Dieu. Nous aujourd'hui, nous avons étudié là, avancé. Nous dans Genèse chapitre 50.
Yes, Genesis 50.
Et verset 15 jusqu'au 26e verset.
Yes.
Et songez bien que nous avons expliqué où l'histoire de la vie de Joseph. Nous dans l'histoire de la vie de Joseph.
We are in the life of Joseph.
Et c'est une vie. Et ça pour me capable dire Joseph son deuxième un type de Christ.
Joseph is like Christ.
Et avant de finir, on va parler qui parallèle qui gagne dans toute étape la vie de Joseph.
We will compare the life of Joseph and Jesus.
Et parce qu'on va voir c'est même bagarre avec la vie de Jésus.
We will see that it is the same thing as the life of Jesus.
Et Joseph que t'es vendu.
Joseph, they sold him.
Et Joseph devient gouverneur.
He became governor.
Et il voulait chercher famille lui dans l'Égypte, dans le pays pour être gouverneur.
He went and get his family to come to live in the place where he was governing.
Les revenus, mais on était bien recevoir non seulement par Joseph et puis par tout le pays.
When his family come, they welcomed them, both Joseph and the king in the town.
Joseph pas de garder sous sa robe ferme.
Joseph did not look at the things that they did to him. He welcomed them and gave them a nice place to stay.
Et malgré frère yo te connait peur li,
Even though his brothers were afraid of him.
Mais il y a une promesse que papa Joseph te dit frère.
There's something that Joseph brothers Joseph father told his brothers.
Eh bien, il te dit que nous vraiment de Joseph pardon.
He said that we must ask Joseph for forgiveness. When they get to Egypt,
I'm capable to say sincerely that Jacob is bénit pays.
When they get to Egypt, Jacob had blessed the country.
He bénit Pharaoh.
He blessed Pharaoh.
He bénit tout petit Léo.
He blessed all his children.
Parce que Joseph a gagné deux petits.
Joseph had two children.
Mais dans deux petits Joseph, il te dit Joseph que la prend deux petits ça pour lui.
Joseph two children. Jacob welcomed them as his own.
Et nous voyons dans Genèse chapitre 49.
We'll see in Genesis 49.
Et bien, on y a réuni tout petit Léo.
He called all his children.
Et bien, ils ont eu la bénédiction.
And then he blessed them.
Et il a de bénédiction, il a bénédiction tout à deux petits Joseph.
And he also blessed Joseph's two children.
Pour qui ça a béni deux petits Joseph?
Why did he bless Joseph's two children?
Et parce que te dit que ma prend au petit moi.
Because he said that he would take them as his own.
Il a béni 12 petits lui même.
When he was blessing his 12 children,
sa déclaration fait sous dos Joseph là.
The declaration that he made on Joseph.
Il mettait au c'est pas pour Joseph exactement, pour tomber mais c'est pour son petit monde lui.
But he didn't make them directly for Joseph, but he made it for Joseph's two children.
Et parce que c'est deux petits monde ça qui va devenir grand en pays.
Because it is those two children that's going to be powerful in the town.
Et bien, pour nous, il dit nous que Jacob arrive dans l'heure pour nous mourir.
Now it says that Jacob come a time when he's about to die.
Et bien, et Jacob te promet que tu es capable, te promet, te demande Joseph pour Joseph pas atterrir dans l'Égypte.
Jacob asked Joseph that he not be buried in Egypt.
Parce qu'il était enterré.
Because he wanted to be buried.
La caille.
In his hometown.
Parce que c'est la papa.
Because that's where his father.
Un grand papa.
His grandfather.
Et bien c'est là où il était enterré.
That's where they were buried.
Ça veut dire papa lui c'est Isaac.
Because his father is Isaac.
Et grand papa c'était Abraham.
His grandfather was Abraham.
Et bien, il était censé vraiment littéralement pour enterrer le même potentiel avec papa.
He asked to be buried next to his father.
Madame Lato.
He said he buried his wife there.
Et bien, c'est là où l'enterrer.
And that's where he needs to be buried.
Et bien, et Joseph te fait même bagaille ça.
And then Joseph asked for the same thing.
Et c'est juste un bon groupe de faire groupe de capable vivre dans Genèse chapitre 50 verset 15 ans.
Okay, this is just a preview to get into Genesis 50 verse 15.
Donc à faire prier à mon arrivé à nous lire à partir de Genèse chapitre 50 verset 50 verset 15.
Let's read Genesis 50 verse 15.
Il dit non comme que Joseph, eh bien Joseph mourit en Égypte.
When Joseph died in Egypt.
Mais Joseph rassurait frère Léo que lui-même n'est pas Dieu. Lui là pour pardonner, il pas qu'il doit tirer revanche peut-être pas.
When he assured his brothers that hey, he is not God, he is not there to bring vengeance against them.
Okay, nous lire verset 15.
Let's read verse 15.
When Joseph's brothers died, their father
Isaac died.
When their father was dead, they said, "What if Joseph held the grip against us and paid us back for all the wrong we did to him?"
Et songez bien que et monsieur yo, ça veut dire en parlant de 11 frères Joseph yo, en Éthiopie, 10 frères Joseph, ils ont même fait un complot contre lui-même pour être capable de vendre Joseph.
Remember that Joseph, 10 of Joseph's brothers planned to sell Joseph off.
Eh bien, ils ont fait Joseph un mal.
They did a wrong to Joseph.
Eh bien, ils ont vu qu'on y a dans un état côté que ils sous ordre Joseph.
And now they come to a place now where they were all under Joseph's control.
Parce que Joseph qu'on y a là c'est gouverneur pays, il est salvé le gars.
Now, because now Joseph is the governor of the country, so whatever he want to do, he can.
Et songez bien que
remember.
Et conscience frère yo par rapport à et ça vous fait à vous révéler de vous révéler conscience.
The conscience of the ten brothers revealed to them what they did.
Yo douté le fait que côté yo ils ont senti que yo pas en sécurité de pardon.
They feel right now in their life they are not secure enough to feel forgiven.
Mais ils oublient toute affection que Joseph a pour eux.
But they forget all the affection that Joseph had for them, all the love he had for them.
Mais il y a une intervention.
But there is an
intercession que Jacob t'a fait en faveur et petit Léo. Ça veut dire toute sa mauvaise parole que vous avez gagné, toute mauvaise action que vous avez fait Joseph. Vous êtes capable de demander Joseph pardon.
They forget that Isaac has speaking favor of the ten brothers for them to ask Joseph for forgiveness.
And we'll go to verse 16.
Let's read on chapter 16.
So they speak a word to Joseph, say, your father left you destruction before he died.
Okay. Qui ça frère a dit Joseph?
What did the brother wait to tell Joseph?
Il y a le fait qu'ils n'ont pas senti en sécurité de pardon.
The fact that they don't feel secure enough to be forgiven.
Eh bien, et ils ont songé papa a été dit en bagage.
They remember their father said something.
Eh bien, ils ont dit comme ça que bon et qu'on y a là, nous prenons côté Joseph.
He said, right now I'm gonna go tell Joseph.
Nous prenons dit Joseph, ça va pas de dire.
I'm gonna tell Joseph what my father said.
Et bien, qu'on y a là, ils ont allé côté Joseph.
And now they went to see Joseph.
Il dit mais qui ça va pas de dire oui.
This is what my father said before he died.
Et dans le verset 17.
Verse 17.
This is what you are to say to Joseph. I ask you to forgive your brother the sin in the wrong they committed and treated you so bad. Now please forgive the sin of your servant of God, of your father. When their mercy came to come to you.
Okay. Qui ça Joseph senti les messieurs au vin côté?
What did Joseph feel like when the brothers went to see him?
Joseph, son contentement, Joseph bien.
He felt happy when he saw his brothers coming to see him.
Au contraire, sous ta gagne, parents qui mourit, on y a ouvin ou frère qui était papier, on y a ouvin yo vin la caille.
If you saw your parent died and then your brothers who was not close to you suddenly come to your home to get closer towards you.
Eh bien, ou même qui vient cap recevoir frère, yo en sens ou content dans la joie.
You that's welcoming them will feel happy that they come to see you.
Eh bien, mais si on pas nous un jour spécialement nos appréciation, mais on est venu demander Joseph, on est venu dire Joseph et yon bagay spécial.
Well, they didn't come to see Joseph because they appreciated Joseph, but they came to see him for something specific.
Parce que papa a été dit au conseil que yo l'ai même lui mouri, il va lui demander Joseph pardon pour tout crime, pour tout ça que fait Joseph là, et son crime que fait Joseph, il va lui demander Joseph pardon.
The father, when Isaac died, he told them, he told the ten brothers. go to Joseph and ask forgiveness for the crime that they had committed toward Joseph.
Gen yon bagay ki pwodwi, le Joseph tande sa, la Bible di Joseph kriye paske li menm nan kè li pa ki hann gen bagay, hen nan kè li pa apwa sa ou li fè.
When Joseph heard what his brother said, he cried. The Bible said that he cried because he never had any grudges, any anger toward his brothers. That's something that you need to know.
Frère Joseph, yo, Joseph pardonné yo depuis des temps passés.
Joseph brothers, Joseph had forgiven them long time ago.
Mais yo même nan cœur yo, yo toujours pensé que Joseph pas pardonné yo.
His brothers thought that in their heart that Joseph never really forgive them for real.
Et bien kounya la sak passé, c'est même gens que nous même tout sous terre.
It's just like us right now in this earth.
Et bien là nous fait bon Dieu on va faire tout.
When we do something wrong to God,
et bien kounya la nous pensé bon Dieu va pardonner nous vrai.
We may think that God did not forgive us for real.
Et bon Dieu lui l'a pardonné, le pardonné.
And when God forgives, He forgives.
Eh bien, Joseph dit, monsieur, yo,
Joseph told them,
pouvez yo pas crier, crier, ça veut dire pour lui-même, ça veut dire son, c'est remind. Donc, par exemple, c'est songer. Joseph vient, monsieur vient faire songer ça que yo te fait, Joseph.
Because Joseph cried, they thought it's because they made Joseph remember all the pain that they had caused him.
Et Joseph te blie,
and Joseph had forgive all of
them.
And sometimes God forget everything that we do.
And
yet we still keep it in our
mind.
We still keep on asking God for forgiveness. And God had already forgiven us a long time ago. Let's look at verse 18, no matter.
Right then, Joseph's brother came and bowed down to the ground in front of him and said, "We are your slaves."
Eh bien, Joseph, garde monsieur.
Joseph looked at his brother.
Joseph fin crier, monsieur vini au posterné.
When Joseph finish cried, they come down and bow down toward him.
No, c'est monsieur posterné devant Joseph.
The brothers bow down toward Joseph.
Eh bien, Joseph consacré nous ses serviteurs.
They told Joseph that we are your servant.
C'est une fois nous faire. C'est même pas ça passé nous-mêmes une fois des problèmes et on a clop nous pas blessé.
Sometimes we have problem with one another that we are not ready to bow down.
Nous besoin yon baissé devant l'autre.
We need somebody to bow down in front of us.
Parce que c'est l'un de ces pardonner l'autre.
Because it's one another that need to forgive each other.
On nous garde pour nous ça Jésus-Christ dans prière là.
Let's see what Jesus say on his prayer.
Et bien il dit disciple on consacre pour il va dire papa nous qui dans ciel là.
He said Father who are in heaven.
C'est pour nous reconnaître non où.
We
want to you
are. We need to remember
pardonnez péché nous.
Forgive our sin.
Et bien tant qu'on nous pardonne l'autre qui fait nous dire.
As we forgive those who sin against us. Each of us have to learn to forgive each other.
Et bien frère Joseph, yo posterné, attestant que Dieu Joseph consacré nous-mêmes de serviteur qu'on a là, n'a pas travaillé avec eux.
And now the brothers bow down toward Joseph and said, "Hey, we are your servant, and we come to be your slave to work for you."
Mais songez, oui.
But remember,
et deux semaines passées, une semaine passée, nous t'as parlé de et Joseph qui te font vision.
Remember, last week we talked about Joseph who had a vision.
Et le vision Joseph là. Et bien côté que l'ouest fouet lui,
bah,
et bien t'es abaissé devant lui.
And Joseph vision, he saw where his brothers was bowed down in front of him. The brothers had hatred in their heart because of that. And now the brothers are bowing down in front of him.
Et ça fait sentir que plein mon Dieu pour la vie qui quelque chose soit petit prix la réussi quand même.
That make us see that whatever plan that God had for his children, they will happen eventually.
Ça veut dire pas besoin de peur plein mon Dieu gain sous la vie là que personne va pas retirer.
You don't have to be afraid because whatever plan that God has in store for you, no one can take that away from you.
Mais si vous pouvez faire ça dans le contexte, c'est pour vous être capable de prouver Joseph que plein qu'elle te gagne dans tête li attestant que vous même pipi grand passé, vous n'avez pas le conseil devant là, vous n'avez pas réussi.
Even though Joseph was younger than the brothers, Joseph tried to show the brothers whatever plan they had against him, they would not work out. Today I'm trying to tell you that you don't have to be afraid because no one can remove the plan of God in your life. Let's look at verse 20, Lamara.
You tried to harm me, but God made it turn out for the good. So that he could tell all these people as he is my name.
Okay. Anami. Songez bien, nous plein que mon Dieu gagne dans la vie, la personne n'est pas capable de tirer.
Remember, I told you that whatever plan God has in store for you, no one can remove it.
Mais pour plein ça pas, il sorti dans la vie.
But for this plan not to happen in your life.
Eh bien, faut que vous étiez en bas contrôle de Dieu.
But you need to stay under the control of God.
Joseph était en bas contrôle de Dieu.
Joseph stayed under God's control.
Eh bien, c'est raison ça qui fait aujourd'hui à Joseph arriver.
That is the reason that Joseph achieved to the power that he is today.
Eh bien, on y a là, Joseph, le monsieur, yo pensé que c'est un mal yo de faire Joseph.
Joseph saw that Joseph.
Le monsieur yo de pensé que son mal.
When Joseph brothers thought that they had harmed Joseph.
Eh bien, c'était un bien yo de faire Joseph.
But it was a blessing that they did to Joseph.
Et ou pas une bonne côté que ou pas vite de côté ou côté que non, you can stay. Ou pas vite de côté que Joseph ou al bay monsieur yo yon réponse en verset 20. Et c'est pilier et tout passage là.
You will find on verse 20 where Joseph will answer his brothers, and it's like the main part of the passage.
Well, eh bien, qui s'allie? Joseph dit au conseil que monsieur nous pas de faire rien, nous pas besoin méditer dans que nous pas besoin penser dans que nous ne faisons rien de mal.
He said, but as for you, he thought evil against me, but God meant it for good to bring to pass as it is this day to save much people alive. You don't have to do that. Don't put that in your thought.
Bon Dieu fait ça même arrivé.
God made that happen.
C'est pas notre métier.
It's not you who did it.
Bon Dieu fait c'est pour nous capable sauver une multitude de peuples.
But God did it so I could save multiple people.
Et bien combien monde qui t'ai quitté? Combien monde qui sont contrôlé Joseph? Combien monde dans famille Joseph qui sont contrôlé?
How many people in Joseph's family was under Joseph's control?
Et bien Joseph seulement te rentré en 70 moun sorti Canaan pour entrer en Égypte vivre en Égypte.
Joseph had 70 people from his family that came from Canaan to come to live with him in Egypt. Pay attention.
70. Combien moun sorti en Égypte?
How many people left Egypt people?
Eh bien, combien moun sorti Canaan?
How many people left Canaan?
70.
70 et sorti.
It was 3.
Listen.
Oui. 70 sortis Canaan pour rentrer en Égypte.
70 people left Canaan to come to live in Egypt under Joseph.
C'est un coup Joseph te dit que c'est un coup Joseph t'a dit que nous t'ai fait ça.
It's just as if Joseph wanted to say you did this.
C'est pour bon Dieu te préparer chemin pour nous 70 là t'es capable venir vivre bien.
But it is so that God was preparing the way for the 70 people so that the 70 of you could come to live good with me.
Et bien ça veut dire nous pas besoin de peur rien.
You don't have to be afraid of anything.
Au contraire, je dis à papa mouri, et bien nous même pays a fui pour nous.
And contrary, my father died right now, and now this country is free for you to use.
Okay, numéro 21.
Verse 21, Namara.
Don't be afraid. I will take care of you and your children. And Joseph said this, his brother felt much better.
Okay, qui ça le dit là? Il dit, on pense à quel droit besoin de rien.
You don't have to worry about anything.
Nous pas besoin de faire rien.
You don't have to worry about anything.
Parce que
because
là, nous en sécurité.
Because right now you're in security.
Ma nous tout ça nous.
I'll provide everything that you need.
Et ni nous même ni petite nous.
Both for you and your children.
Et nous pas besoin de faire papa nous en crier moi m'a consoler nous là pour consoler.
Even though you are crying, but I will be there to comfort you.
Et Joseph, la vie de Joseph était constamment à parler avec vous, conscientiser vous, pour permettre que vous pas mettre tête vous, pour enlever sa cœur vous, qui s'est fait Joseph yon mal.
The Bible says that Joseph constantly talked with his brothers to reaffirm to them that, hey, everything that happened in the past is the past, so let's move on.
Eh bien, et la Bible dit que
the Bible said
Joseph occupait Monsieur Yo pendant un bon bout de temps.
The Bible said that Joseph took care of his brothers for a long time.
Il occupait bien.
He took care of them well.
Eh bien, ça veut dire Joseph a pas approché vers la mort du tout.
And you find where Joseph is getting older and getting ready to die.
Et bien, on y a là, on nous verset 22.
Let's, Christina, verse 22.
Jonah stayed in Egypt along with his father from when he lived in 110 years.
Okay. Combien qu'il a Joseph vu mourir?
How old was Joseph when he died?
110.
Ça veut dire Joseph, pardonne-moi. Joseph a vécu en Égypte combien de temps?
Joseph lived in Egypt for how many years?
110 ans.
He lived in Egypt for 110 years.
Ok. Et 110 ans, et que il était en Égypte. Il a vécu 110 ans. Ça veut dire Joseph passer toute la vie, pas en Égypte exactement, non, toute la vie, Joseph. Ça veut dire, on est bien dit, à 23 ans, rentrer en Égypte, et au Galoué, et dans combien de temps, il est passé en Égypte, là.
Joseph entered Egypt at the age of 23, and you will see how many years he spent in Egypt.
Eh bien, ça veut dire que,
that means
Joseph passé et Joseph mourit à 110 ans.
He died at 110.
Ok, on nous continue. On nous continue verset 23.
Let's read verse 23.
And saw the third generation of Abraham's children, also the children of Maker. So, Lisa were placed at birth of Joseph.
Yo dit que pendant tout temps que Joseph fait en Égypte là,
to tell about the whole time that Joseph spent in Egypt,
songez bien que Joseph a gagné deux petites.
He had only two children.
Eh bien, et dans deux petites, il y a
deux
Ephraim.
There's one he called Ephraim.
Eh bien, Ephraim, il dit comme ça que Joseph répétit jusqu'à la troisième génération.
Joseph saw his children even toward the third generation.
Là, on dit troisième génération. Qui ça veut dire?
When they talk about the third generation, what do they mean by that?
Ça veut dire que Joseph voit trois petits qui fait petit devant.
He saw three of his children that had children in front of him. That means he has his
grandma.
His grandma.
Par exemple, grandma ouais petit ou même.
That's second generation.
Yes. No.
That's first. Second.
Second. And then petit.
Petit, so I'm gonna make third.
Mettez au petit.
Oh, that's like okay. That's like my.
Trois. Okay. Trois et troisième génération. Ça veut dire trois petit lit fait petit.
Oh, okay.
Well, troisième génération. Okay. Yo dit que. Et jusqu'à alors et au team Joseph jusqu'à la troisième génération.
Until the third generation.
Mm-hmm, et où vient joindre que et les fils des Maquis, ça veut dire Maquis c'est petit Manassé. Fils de Manassé.
You see that Machi the son of Manassé.
Il dit Manassé, petit Manassé au fait en renoul.
No, Manasseh's children were growing up in front of Joseph.
Songez bien que Ephraim c'est premier petit Joseph.
Remember that Ephraim was the first child of Joseph.
Et Manasseh c'est deuxième petit Joseph.
And Manasseh is the second children of Joseph.
Uh-huh. On va aller verset 24.
Verse 24.
Then Joseph said to his brothers, I am about to die, but God will surely come to your aid and take you out of this land to the land He promised. Out to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Okay. Regardez. Et Joseph, vous vivez dans l'âge, changez de vie, nous tout consacrer Joseph, vous vivez dans l'âge, oui.
Remember that Joseph come a time where he is about to die.
À l'âge de 110 ans.
At the age of 110.
Mais tout petit lui au fait dans mère.
All his children was born in front of him.
Mais qu'on y a là Joseph arrivé dans dernier l'heure où t'es pour mourir.
And now Joseph come a time where he's about to die.
Et bien lui avec toute famille Israël.
Now he called all of his children of Israel.
Et les parler de famille Israël là.
When I talk about the children of Israel.
Parler de tout 70 là.
He talk about the whole 70.
Et plus ça au fait dans pays encore.
Plus the children that they made while they were living in the land.
Plus petit Joseph. Yo.
Plus Joseph's children.
Et bien Joseph really.
Joseph called him.
Et bien Joseph dit comme ça que moi-même on va mourir dans moment ça.
Well, I'm about to die at this moment.
Il dit comme ça que bon Dieu vient pour visiter nous.
God had to visit you.
Eh bien, comme Joseph, ça veut dire comme Joseph était vaincu pour tes victoires dans la vie.
Saint Joseph had victory over his life.
Eh bien, il vient avec ferme conviction, Joseph dit monsieur yo, non, et bon Dieu vient vous visiter.
With firm conviction, Joseph told them that God who had to visit you.
Son promesse que Joseph fait sur famille Israël.
It is a promise that Joseph did on the Israelite family. Let's look at Hebrew 11.
Mm-hmm. Hebrew chapter 11 verse 22.
Hebrew 11. Hebrew 11 verse 22. Hebrew 11 verse 22. Anybody have it? Please read. By faith Joseph, when he died, made mention of the departing of the children of Israel. And gave commitment according concerning his bones.
Okay. Joseph dit monsieur yo, par la foi.
Joseph told them by faith.
Eh bien, bon Dieu vient pour visiter.
God had to visit you.
Et lors de San Diboboal, ouais, ça va passer. Oui, il dit comme ça que les bons gens visitent nous.
He said when Jesus visits you.
C'est pour nous pas quitter même zone dans pays ça.
When Jesus visits you, I don't even want you to leave my bones in this land.
And nous parlons de nos promesses après la vie accomplie. Oui.
You will see that this promise is accomplished.
And nous arrivons dans nous répéterons par où est dans Exode où on va voter pour mettre ça après la vie accomplie.
When we get to Exodus, we will see how this promise is accomplished.
Et près de 200 ans après,
almost 200 years later,
and on va venir à côté que bon Dieu pour attendre cri peuple ça.
You will see where God is going to call, hear the cry of his people.
Parce que c'est pour ça que dans le Hébreux chapitre 11:22, il dit que c'est par la foi que Joseph dit monsieur que bon Dieu vous visiter.
That is why that I read Hebrews 11 verse 22 because you will see that it is by faith that Joseph told them that God will have to visit you.
Et bien c'est pourquoi dans verset 25 là, et Joseph il jure là.
You will see in verse 25 where Joseph is ruling, is ruling at that
time.
In verse 25, and Joseph took an oath of the children of Israel, saying, God will surely visit you, and he shall carry out my bones from hence.
Eh bien, Wally, eh bien, la Bible dit, Wally, regardez dans Exode chapitre 13.
If you look at Exodus verse 13,
le verset 9, Exode, ben, on va regarder.
Exodus 13, verse 9. And it shall be a sign unto thee upon thy hand, and for a mention between thy eyes, that the Lord's law may be
19, right?
No, verse 9.
19.
Verse 19. Okay, 13, verse 19. And Joseph took the bones of, and Moses took the bones of Joseph with him, for he had strictly sworn the children of Israel, saying, God will surely visit you, and ye shall carry up my bones away hence with you.
Eh bien, ça veut dire, Wally, c'est après 400 ans.
He says, after 400 years.
C'est après 400 ans après.
It's after 400 years later.
Eh bien, ou pas, il y a une promesse à vie d'accomplir.
That you see where we are reading right now.
Lorsque la Bible parle de, lorsque vous parlez du 4e siècle, 4 siècles après, c'est 400 années.
When we talk about four cycles later, when they talk about four cycles later, they talk about 400 years later.
Eh bien, vous parlez d'un côté que les Moïse a quitté l'Égypte.
When Moses is leaving Egypt, you will see where he even pick up the Joseph bones and carry it with him.
Eh bien, est-ce que vous avez la Bible ça?
Where did they put the bones?
Songez bien que Joseph était juré pour que vous ne quittiez Zoli même dans le pays d'Égypte.
Remember that Joseph orders not for them not to even leave his bone in Egypt. Let's see in Joshua 24. Joshua 24:22. Verse 22 is the last book of Joshua, close to Jude.
Joshua
24.
Verse
24.
Yeah.
And the people said unto Joshua, the Lord our God will we serve, and his voice will we obey. Verse 24. Verset 24, verset 24?
Non.
Joshua 24, verset 24?
Non, 32.
Verset 32, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Joshua 24, verse 32, and it read, and the bones of Joseph, which the children of Israel brought up out of Egypt, buried they in Shechem, and a parcel of ground which Jacob bought of the son of Hamor, the father of Shechem, for 100 pieces of silver, and it became the inheritance of the children of Joseph.
Joseph. Oui, ça veut dire, songez bien, oui, nous voyons que Joseph fait promesse là, à peuple là, dans verset 24.
Mm-hmm.
Il dit que c'est pour que nous ne pas quitter même zone dans le pays à l'endroit.
Oui.
C'est bon Dieu qui vient visiter nous, pour venir chercher nous pour là.
We'll see that Joseph made the promise on verse 24, not even to leave my bones in Egypt, and because God would have to come and visit you. The reason that the people of Israel was
Joseph te grandi Egypt en pile, bénédiction mondiale tombée en Egypt.
Remember, it's because Joseph grew up in Egypt, and the blessing of God was on the people of Egypt.
Eh bien, bon Dieu lui-même, il était préparé un chemin pour les grandir peuple en Égypte. Peuple a été très nombreux.
The remember that God was building a way to grow up His people in Egypt, and the people had become really large.
Eh bien, Égypte. Coutume égyptien avec coutume israélite tout pas même.
The Egyptian custom and the Israelites are not the same.
Et bien qu'on y a là et que il vit mon problème. Roi qui était là, c'est Pharaon qui était là. Il est mort.
And we have a problem where the old king, the old Pharaoh that was there before had died.
Un deuxième pharaon qui est monté, il va connaître l'histoire de Joseph là-même.
And the second pharaoh that thou was there do not have no history of Joseph past.
Il va connaître l'histoire, bon Dieu n'a parlé de lui même.
You don't have no history of the God that we are talking about.
Et bien qu'on y a là, il va maltraiter peuple
Israël. And now he come and he mistreated the people of Israel.
Parce que ils ont loi en Égypte. Ils ont loi en Égypte, toute terre en Égypte c'est pour Pharaon.
And there's a law in Egypt where every piece of land that's in Egypt belong to the king, Pharaoh.
Ça veut dire tout le monde qui travaille en Égypte va travailler quoi?
That means everyone who work in Egypt work for the king.
Except the preachers.
Except for the priests. Except the pastors. And the priests.
Okay. C'est seulement eux même terre ou pas pour pouvoir.
Only their land do not belong to.
Jusqu'à maintenant.
Until now.
Parce que la Bible dit jusqu'à 13 ans que en Égypte bon loi comme ça, eh bien toute terre en Égypte appartient à roi.
Oh, even until now, every land in Egypt belong to the king.
Roi travaille terre, mais c'est pour roi travail.
You will work the land, but the land will be for the king, where you will share the
property. And what is 400 years after?
They said 400 years later.
Qu'on y a la promesse que bon Joseph t'a fait sur peuple là.
Remember the promise that Joseph had on people.
Et bien qu'on y a la il a accompli.
It become accomplished.
Attention. C'est pourquoi ils viennent prendre Joseph, ils viennent prendre Zod, les Moïse dans notre livre pour dans Genèse. Lorsque dans le Exode chapitre 13 verset 19.
When we read Exodus 13 verse 19.
Et bien pendant Moïse, bon Dieu t'a envoyé, Moïse a cherché peuple en Égypte.
When God said Moses to get the people out of Egypt.
Et bien qu'on y a un frère qui nous raconte que Joseph et Moïse prend Zo corps de Joseph est enterré en Égypte.
You will see where Joseph pick up. Well, you will see where Moses pick up Joseph's bones that was buried in Egypt. And he left Egypt with
him. Mission Moïse va finir en route.
But Joseph's mission will finish while in transition. And now Joshua will take his place. And now Joseph becomes responsible for Joshua becomes responsible for Joseph's bones.
And now they take
the bones and they bury them all the way in Shechem.
Ça veut dire Joseph a rentré dans territoire, dans position où il t'a donné.
And now you see where Joseph will be buried, where he was supposed to be buried.
À quel âge que Joseph mourit, soit il le dit ça déjà.
We'll see at what age that Joseph is actually.
À nos verset 26, ça vous finit, c'est ça?
He buried verse 26 tomorrow.
Vous finissez.
Genesis 50. Genesis 50, verse 26.
So Joseph died in Egypt at the age of 110. His body was embalmed and put in a coffin.
Yo dit que Joseph mourit à quel âge?
À 110.
110. Mais en pauvre, ils mettent le nom secret
en Égypte.
En Égypte. Donc, dis-moi ça que yo qualifié, c'est en 1804.
They said that he died at the year of 804.
Et avant Jésus.
AD, before Christ.
Léo dit qu'on s'appelle 1804 avant Jésus-Christ. Comment est-ce qu'on dit Jacques avant Jésus-Christ?
When they said AD before Jesus Christ, how did they calculate the dates?
Eh bien, on dit qu'on s'appelle.
They said.
Ils ont contrôlé de là-haut vers le bas.
They start from the highest number and work their way down.
Et bien, on dit qu'on s'appelle que c'est non époque. On dit qu'on s'appelle classifié non époque de. C'est 1841.
They said they started with 1841.
C'est jusqu'en 1841 ou 1792.
To 1792 AD.
Avant Jésus-Christ.
Before Jesus Christ.
Il dit que c'est époque ça Pharaon. C'est époque ça Pharaon qui régnait sur tout le territoire. Le deuxième Pharaon.
They said it is during that time that the second Pharaoh became in power.
Et c'est raison ça qui fait comme si que ou voilà dans époque ça c'est en 1525 et bien on va venir avant Jésus-Christ ou pas venir avec la naissance de Moïse.
You see that 1025 AD.
Twenty-five
AD, that's where they come up with Moses.
La vie de Moïse.
That's where we start discussing the life of Moses.
Premièrement,
we said first of all,
Joseph mourit à 110 ans.
That Joseph died at 110.
400 ans après.
400 years after.
Eh bien, Joseph te font promesse que tu es sorti avec Isolie.
Joseph made a promise to leave Egypt with his bones. And now this promise become a reality 400 years later. Where did they bury Joseph's body?
At Shechem. C'est là où t'as enterré Joseph.
as you shame. That's where they bury the Joseph bones. I think today is the last time we're talking about Joseph. But we need to it is important to parallel Joseph's life.
Et quand dit Joseph, il semble à son type de Christ lié.
They say that Joseph is like have the same. It's like Christ.
Et un nous garde pour nous.
Let's look and see.
Si, la fois comparaison la vie Joseph avec la vie de Christ.
We will compare the life of Joseph and the life of Christ.
Si vous regardez dans Genèse chapitre 37 verset 2.
If you look at Genesis 37 verse 22.
Joseph c'était un berger.
Joseph was a shepherd.
Eh bien, il dit que et sous-gardez Jésus-Christ.
Regardez
Jean chapitre 10, moi ça passe.
If you look at James chapter 10.
Joseph c'est berger papa l'idée. On a le à Jésus-Christ dit pour dans Jean chapitre 10 verset.
Let's look at what the Bible said about
Jésus.
About Jesus Christ and James Peter.
10 11.
Oh James.
Jean.
Oh, I'm sorry. James.
Oh, not James.
Oh. And John 10. John 10, verse 11, it says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep.
Okay. Songez bien que ça fait être Joseph.
Remember why they took Joseph?
Eh bien, Joseph, je dis que dans Genèse chapitre 37.
They said then,
Genèse 37, verset 2.
They said in Genesis 37, verse 2.
Joseph, c'était un berger, il était.
Joseph was a shepherd.
Ok, très bien. Et Jésus-Christ, nous montrons Jésus-Christ dans le premier passage, c'est l'énergie, pas ça?
They said in the first passage that Jesus was the shepherd.
Eh bien, on a le mot, dans Genèse chapitre 37, verset 3.
Genèse chapter 37, verse 3.
Genèse 37,
verse 3.
Eh bien, on dit pour ça que Joseph était aimé par papa, papa Joseph était aimé en pile.
You see that Joseph's father loved him a lot.
Mais sous la de Matthieu chapitre 3 verset 17.
If you look at Matthew chapter.
Dans Matthieu chapitre 3 verset 17.
And if you look at Matthew 3 verse 17. It says, from that time Jesus began to preach.
Matthieu 3 17.
And Lord, a voice from heaven saying, this is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased.
Ça veut dire Wally? Ça veut dire Joseph te l'aimé papa Bali?
Joseph was loved by his father.
Et bien Jésus-Christ l'aimé papa Bali.
And Jesus was loved by his father.
On allait dans verset 4 là, dans Genèse chapitre 4. Genèse 4, on dit ça que Joseph raï par frère yo.
Let's see in Genesis 4 verse
Genèse 4 verset Genèse 37 verset 4.
Genesis 37 verse 4.
Eh bien, il dit que Joseph était raï par frère. Le frère Joseph était raï.
Joseph brothers hated.
Regardez dans Jean 7 pour ça passe.
Let's look at John 7 and
3.
John 7. John 3.
Non, c'est 7.
7. John 7, 3. It says, John 7, 5.
John 3 to 5.
Verse 3 to 5. It said, his brother therefore said unto him, depart hence and go into Judea, that thy disciples also may see the work that thou doest. For there is no man that doeth anything in secret, and he himself seeketh to be known openly. If thou do this thing, show thyself to the world. For neither did his brothers believe in him. Then Jesus said unto them, My time is not yet come, but your time is always ready. The world cannot hate you, but me it is hating, is hate big, because I testify of it, that the works thereof are evil.
Okay, ça veut dire, vous voyez, oui, ça veut dire, Jésus-Christ est venu, qui ça a fait, il a eu Jésus.
Il a eu.
Et qui ça a fait, il dit comme ça que, moment là, pour pouvoir vivre, il faut qu'il m'a eu. Ça t'est passé, Joseph. Moment Joseph là, pour pouvoir vivre, il t'a eu Joseph.
But then,
et on va rapidement voir le dernier Joseph.
Yes.
Est-ce que ouais? Ça veut dire qu'on a comparé Joseph, toute la vie Joseph, toute étape Joseph là, c'est même la vie Christ là. C'est pourquoi on compare Joseph comme un deuxième type de Christ.
That's we compare Joseph as the is like is his life is almost like Jesus life, because when Joseph come into the world, they hated Joseph, but Joseph's time was not yet. And then when Jesus come, they hated Jesus. And well, that's how they compare.
Mbaga finili parce que il faut faire le bagayo. Bam le on sait bagay.
Let's read one more part.
Ça qui est important, des notions évêques. Dans Genèse 50 verset 20.
Remember that Genesis 50 verse 20, he says.
Songez ça, Joseph t'a dit.
Remember what Joseph said.
Joseph dit que
Joseph said,
ça nous fait là, c'est pas nous qui fait, nous pas fait un.
Joseph said, whatever you did, it wasn't you who did it. Y'all didn't do nothing to it.
Bon Dieu t'a fait, c'est pour capable de sauver un bon monde de nous.
But Jesus, God let this happen so I will be able to save a lot of
people. C'est pour être capable de changer mal, bon Dieu changer mal en bien.
So it was so God could change the bad to good.
And what were we? Not the Corinthians. God, not the Corinthians.
Let's look at 2 Corinthians.
5. The Corinthians chapter 2, verses 7-8.
2 Corinthians 2. It's next to Galatians, is it? 2 Corinthians 2, verse 5, it said, but if
7.
Seven. For thought I made you sorry. For with a letter, I do not repent. Though I did repent, for I received that the same apostle had made you sorry. Thought it were but for a season.
First Corinthians 2, verse 7-8.
But we speak the wisdom of God and mysteries. Even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory, which none of the princes of this world knew. For had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory.
Yeah, ça veut dire, Wally, on y a là, la Bible dit comme ça que. Si monsieur vient dire nous état qu'on est côté que si on est connu il va t'appeler
Joseph. The Bible said that it's like if the If the brothers knew what Joseph would become, they would not have sold Joseph off to slavery.
Et mes amis, bagay la toujours du bon, ça que si nous te connais l'autre dia.
If it's the same things like if we knew today,
et bien nous pas capable vendre Jésus-Christ.
We would not have sold Jesus.
Et bien, vous bien que vous vendez Jésus-Christ.
Remember that they sold Jesus.
Et pour 3 siècles d'argent.
For nearly 3 little silvers.
Ils ont vendu Joseph.
And then they sold Joseph.
Et bien, what's the name?
It's the same thing.
Que bon Dieu bénisse nous.
May God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Woo. Okay, are we ready for some questions?
Yes.
Are we ready for some questions? Are we ready to answer some question according to the word of God? We're going to make it very easy today, okay?
Yay!
Great. I'm going to call on to Junior. Please do not answer. Let him answer. If he do not answer, then we'll call on somebody else. Remember, your reward is what you earn. If you don't earn it, you don't get it. Okay? Why did Joseph's brothers seek his forgiveness? Why did Joseph's brother went to see Joseph and ask for forgiveness? Let me say it like that for you, Junior. There's a case you wasn't paying attention last week in district class, okay? If somebody do something bad towards you, right? Like if your brother's at your house, your brothers and your sisters at the house, right? If they did something bad to you, okay? Why would they go ask you for forgiveness? Why would they go and say, "Oh, Junior, I'm so sorry, Junior"? Why would they go do that to you?
Because they feel sorry.
And what else? What else? Why would they feel sorry? Come on, Junior. You know the answer. Okay. It's on Genesis 50, verse 17. You are right, because they felt sorry. But the Genesis 50, verse 17 said, he said, they knew they had done a very evil thing to Joseph, right? They knew they did something really bad to Joseph. That's why they had to go to Joseph and ask for forgiveness, right? You cannot ask for forgiveness unless you know that you did something bad. Lomaro, next question is for you. What demand did Joseph make to the children of Israel concerning his death? What demand did Joseph make to the children of Israel concerning his death? We talk about that a lot. We constantly, we took a nice 20 minutes talking about that part. When Joseph was about to die, he told the children of Israel to do one thing. When he died. Don't answer that, Christina. Please don't answer the question. Hurry up, please.
Oh, yeah, no. He told his brothers. He won't
live this time. No. They know you won't live this long, but he's about to die. So what was the promise he made? What demand did Joseph make to the children of Israel concerning his death?
He promised them that God would lead him out the country.
No. You know it. Keep going. What else? Keep going. You read it. That's the one you read.
Yep.
What did he demand of them? What did he tell them to do? What did he order the people to do after he died?
Take his body with
him. To take his body to where?
To
Take his body or take his what? What was the word the Bible used?
Bone.
Uh-huh. And what else? With the rest. What else?
Christina,
stop. Okay. Junior, stop. You almost got it. Verse 25, you almost had it. He told them to take his body back to the promised land. And he shall carry up my bones from hence. Okay, you're right. He said to take out his body, his bones, from there. Christina, why he didn't want, why he asked them to take his bones to the promised land? Why did he ask that?
Because of bad things are happening.
Why did he want them to take his bones out of Egypt? There was a specific reason. We talked about that last week and this week. Can somebody answer that question? Whoever answers it gets something, you know, you earn what you get. You ain't for free no more. You gotta earn it. Come on, Christina, answer it. The pastor can answer it too. The pastor don't want to answer it here until the answer. Okay, anybody else want to answer it? Lamaba, you want to answer it? Okay.
He want to go where Joseph, Isaac, and Jacob, and Abraham had him.
He want to go to, he want to live and live at live. He wants to be buried close to his ancestors, so his family had lived, had died and buried. Okay, but there was a specific reason. There's a specific reason why he did not want to stay. Why he didn't want his bones to be in Egypt. Why he didn't want his bones to be buried in Egypt. There's a reason why. There's a reason why he didn't want his bones to be buried in Egypt. Anybody know the reason? Anybody, Lamar Jr.? Anybody know why he didn't want his bones to be buried in Egypt? Okay, when they do Bible class, you gotta listen. Don't just stay there daydreaming and looking at the air, looking outside. Gotta, you know, come on now, gotta pay attention. He didn't want his bones to be buried in Egypt because their custom, because he was an Israelite, right? He's from Israel, he's an Israelite, a chosen people by God, right? And the Egyptians had their own custom, their own belief. They didn't believe in God like he believed in God, right? They didn't believe in God. The Egyptians used to worship the trees, the stars. They see the window. Ooh, this is a nice window. So let me bow down to the window. Let me bow down to the chair. They worship anything and everything. Okay? That's the Egyptian. They believe in everything and everything. But the Israelites, they worship God. So they were separate. They was apart. So he didn't want to be left behind in Egypt. He wanted his body to be buried in where? What town? Where he wanted his body to be buried? Where he wanted his body to be buried?
Hmm?
Where he wanted his body to be buried? Anybody know the answer to that? Please raise your hand. Don't call out the answer. Okay, he wanted his body to go toward the promised land, and he wanted, and because he wanted to go to Shechem. Okay? You feel? Now, one more thing. Can somebody tell me what was the main verse for today, the memory verse for today? Go ahead. Huh? The memory verse for today, what was that? The memory verse? The verse I said, this is the memory verse for the day.
21.
No, it was not 21.
20?
Verse 20. What does verse 20 say? That's two. Excuse me. What does verse 20 say?
You tried to harm me, but God made it turn out for the best so that he could save all people as he is now doing.
Okay. Because Joseph, verse 20, but as for you, he thought evil against me, but God meant it unto good to bring to pass at an end. It is this day to save much people. Okay, so how many years after the death of Joseph?
100!
That's right. Shh, David, stop. And who carries Joseph's bones? Excuse me, I'm not even finished.
Moses!
Thank you, David. Moses, you all right. He can't, he ain't know the answer. How many? But he know the answer. He was not here, but he heard the answer and he knows it. Okay, that's right. Thank you, David. Okay, now, was Moses able to carry the bone to the promised land? Somebody answer the question. Junior.
Yes.
David.
No.
Why? That's two. Why? Okay, Junior, since you started it, why? Why Moses was not able to bring the bones to the promised land?
Because
Why was Moses not able to get to the promised land? If you come on, rewatch the video. Died. Huh?
He died.
Answer the question in detail. Why was he not able to go to bring the bones into the promised land? Why was he not able to bring the bones to the promised land? Because he could have bring the bone. If he could have, because he had the chance to go to the promised land. But why wasn't he able to bring it?
Because he don't trust.
Okay, because you're right, partially right. He did die, so that's three.
That I he said did, it.
But no.
Me?
Yeah, that's two, right? That's third question you had right? Or that's third question you had right?
Third.
That's third one, so that's three. Okay, so.
I got two.
Okay, good. How many got in the model? How many got, Christina?
Three.
Okay, good. So now, why was he not able? So that's partially. Those any question? Any partial credit on any partial one only get. Excuse me, I'm talking. Any partial half answer, you only get a minute. For partial answers. So, okay, now. Guys, I want the full answers. I want the full answers. Okay, full answers. Full answers get a full prize. Partial answers get. Okay, you know. Now, partial answers. Why? Anybody know why he didn't go to the promised land?
Oh, he died.
He died. But why? He had a chance.
Then he got too old.
Why?
Because he wanted to. Stay with
Joseph.
His brother, children.
No, Moses didn't go into promised land because he went against God's word.
Yeah, he went.
God gave him a commitment. God gave him an order. He didn't follow through. He did his own. So when you do something against what God wants you to do, you go your own way. In case you was going to get, we just said, I told you to do this. I told Christina, move the chair into right over there by the door. And Christina, move the chair towards the other door. I told her to move it toward that door. And she moved it over there. Was that what I asked her to do?
No.
So that's the same thing that Moses did. He did something opposite from what God said. Okay? God told Moses, hey, talk to the rock, talk to it. Talk to it so water will come out. He went in out of anger, something like you always would do all the time. Even at the house, y'all struck the rock. Or y'all hit the rock. Well, I said, pick up this book and Put that over there. Pick up this cup and put it in the sink. You take the cup and you throw it. It's like pick it up and put it in the sink. But you throw it. Right? So that's the same thing that Moses did. He didn't talk to it. Now he says, hey, what? Because the rock was Jesus. The rock represented Jesus. Represented God. So because he hit the rock.
Yeah.
And God said, talk to it.
And then,
so because of that, God said, hey, you are serving me right. You did a good job for me. I understand you did a good job. You did a good job. But guess what? You did one mistake. And that mistake is a disobedient spirit. God don't like people with a disobedient. He wants you to bow down to him. He wants you to worship him. Do things that he wants you to do according to the way he wants you to do it, not the way you want to do it. So he didn't do that. Anyway, that's another part. Now, one more, or maybe two more. We talked about that a few minutes ago. Who was the person that carried on with Joseph bones? Who?
Jesus.
Who was that was before Jesus? He died before Jesus now. Who was the one that carried on before with Moses' bone? With Joseph bone?
Oh, was it Joshua?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, Joshua.
He carried on.
You should pay attention. Okay, now we're gonna ask one more question. When okay. How was Joseph's body put in the coffin? How was the body put in the coffin?
Mister.
Excuse me. Be quiet.
It was in
there. Embalmed.
Embalmed.
At that time, to him. Be quiet, I'm talking. At that time to embalm the body, that's when they take the body, okay? When somebody died, they take the body, they wash it, they use herbs, they use lettuce. You know, they wash it body real good with perfumes and so they could preserve the body so the body do not stink. They wrap it up just like they do a mummy. You see how mummies are? Exactly. So they wrap it up with herbs and stuff like that, so the body could preserve itself. Because at that time, and they poured him in a coffin, they usually put bodies in what? In tombs. Do you really need a coffin?
And Joseph.
Excuse me, I'm talking.
What the?
I'm gonna remove one of your two, so keep on talking. In a tomb, like Jesus' body, when Jesus was dead, did they put him in a coffin or did they put him in a tomb?
Tomb.
What's the difference between Joseph? Because were they trying to preserve Jesus' body? They were trying to preserve, they put him in a tomb. Because, they quickly buried him. They quickly...
They didn't bury him!
One out. Keep on talking. They quickly, they took Jesus from the cross, they washed him, you know, get him, you know, all preserving everything, right? They preserved his body, but they didn't put him in a coffin.
What's a coffin?
That's where they put grandpa in, where he died. They put him in a coffin, right? But they didn't put Jesus in a coffin, they put him in the tomb. But they put Joseph in a coffin. They put Joseph in a coffin. That's where they put like the kings. When the kings and the priests, somebody of high power, high stature, just like the president just died, or the lady in UK just died, the highest minister in UK just died. They put a nice coffin, right? Like you go to a funeral, the body's in a coffin. But that time. They put the bodies in coffins. I'm going to ask this question again. So pay attention. Later on, next time, we will ask the question again. So pay attention. They put them in coffins because there were people of high power who were put in coffins. It was people of high power that they have embalmed. If you was a poor person, they'll just wrap you up and put you on the tomb. Right?
They put you on the tomb. And then somebody died, they put somebody else on top of you. They put you on the tomb. Okay? But when you are somebody of high power, of high status, they put you in a coffin. That's what happened to him. Now, Divine always do that. Okay. One last question. Did Joseph's brothers believe that Joseph truly forgave him? David?
Don't tell.
I got one.
No. What? Which one is it?
Yes.
Give me the answer. Yes or no? Did he believe that the brothers should forgive him? Yes or no?
No. Yes.
He did not believe the brothers should forgive him. Why? He said. Why is no? That's partial credit. You didn't answer. Yes. Okay. Why? Why?
I'm gonna get a peppermint. I got two.
Okay, good. Why?
Because they did evil things to him.
They did evil things to him, so why did he did not believe that Joseph could forgive them?
Because
why he didn't believe that was possible for Joseph to forgive? Why they thought it was so hard for Joseph to forgive?
Because they had their horrible things to him, and they had started to slay him.
Okay.
And Stephanie.
Because they thought, hey, you know what? If Joseph, partial credit each. I'm gonna finish Bible class. So stop talking. Because they believe that, hey, those bad things I did to Joseph, I saw him and went through all that thing, and now I'm living at Joseph's house, he's taking care of me, he's taking care of my family, he's taking care of the people of Israel. Tell them, all 70 of them, to come and live with me. I don't think he really liked me, and now my father died, you know, daddy just died. So that means the head of the household just died, so that means he's going to take revenge against me. He's gonna try to get even with me. You know what I mean? And sell us off. And why did Joseph's brothers do? Why did they tell Joseph when they went to see him to ask for forgiveness? Why did they tell Joseph when they went to ask for forgiveness?
They left.
Be quiet, please don't call out. You was not there. You was outside playing. You didn't know the answer.
Shh.
What the answer?
Did they get Joseph the instructions?
No. Why did the brothers come on, Lamar?
Oh, they said we're the slaves.
Yes. Thank you very much for. And I have. Thank you very much.
We got four.
Three and a half.
I got two.
Okay. Okay, that's it. Yeah, you got your two back. Okay. Shh. Okay.
You said
yes. Okay. Let us end devotion service for tonight. But before we go, you need to learn that God wants you to forgive those who hurt you. Okay. I know you try to be upset.
Is
I know. That- I'm talking. Even in school, when you upset at school, you need to learn to forgive those who hurt you.
Stephanie.
Okay? You need to forgive those who hurt you. David.
In 70 years.
I'm talking. How many people came from Israel? That's for David.
70.
Thank you. That's how many people that came from Israel to come to live with. Okay, excuse me. Now, one more question, David. How old was Joseph when he
23?
Died?
23?
No. That's for 24? Joseph. No.
24?
That was it. Thank you. 25. That question was already answered. If he was there, you would have heard the answer for that. Too late. Okay. Now, we need to understand that God teaches forgiveness all through the scriptures. All through the scriptures that was reading today, God was teaching us to forgive, the same way Joseph had to forgive his brothers. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, we need to learn that God gave Joseph a happy ending because he obeyed God and forgave his brothers, right? One more thing. Ooh, wow. What is the difference? The pastor compared the two pharaohs, the pharaoh before and the pharaoh after. What was the difference between the two pharaohs? Explain.
Me?
Yes, explain in detail.
Pharaoh's one was nice enough and let people.
Why was he nice?
Like, you were nice to the people and stuff. And then Pharaoh 2, you keep on blasting people.
Why was he nice? What was the difference? The main difference. What was the main difference between Pharaoh and Pharaoh 2? What was the main difference between Pharaoh and Pharaoh 2? David, Pharaoh 1 and Pharaoh 2, what was the main difference? I said that already. I said it and he said it.
Wait.
If I answer it.
Joe, I still got it.
Okay, Pharaoh 1 and Pharaoh 2? Pharaoh 1 was a man who knew about Joseph.
Oh, yeah.
Excuse me. Be quiet, I'm talking. What was the answer, David?
Okay,
since you don't know it, Pharaoh 1 was a man who knew about
Joseph.
He knew he had a boss, even though they was not Christian, they did not, but he obeyed. He had a relationship with God. You know what I mean? He let Joseph have that relationship with God. He let his people. So he welcomed Joseph God. He welcomed God. He welcomed Joseph God. Even though they was worshiping other statues, but he had that relationship with Joseph. Okay? But Pharaoh too did not have no relationship with Joseph. He didn't know nothing about God. He know nothing about Joseph. He know nothing about that. So, and since they was already in Egypt, a place where they're worshiping all the gods, all the religion, their culture and everything else was not the same. Okay? That's the difference. Okay, now let's end devotion service. Can we pray and end? Come on, Christina, please sing for us a little prayer.
Oh, I'm singing.
Go ahead, David. Sing and pray for us, Christina. Go ahead.
Jesus, oh, one more time.
His name is Jesus. Jesus.
So.
I will say this is the day that the Lord let's pray.
Forgive other people who have sinned and other people who have did wrong and didn't know what they did, and give thanks to the people who have came to church today and learn about more about you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Give grace. Grace. Benediction. Let's stand.
Que l'amour de Dieu le Père, la douce et intime bonne communion Saint-Esprit Saint soit et demeure dans nos cœurs, dès à présent, au siècle des siècles. Amen.
Amen.